প্রেমনে ধরিতাম গে। আমি গৌরাঙ্গ বলিয়া না গে নু গালিয়া প্রেমনে ধরিনু দে। আমি গৌরাঙ্গ বলিয়া না গে নু গালিয়া প্রেমনে ধরিনু দে। বাসুরিয়া পাষাণ দিয়া প্রেমনে গদিয়াছে। বাসুরি বাসুরিয়া পাষাণ দিয়া প্রেমনে গদিয়াছে। যদি গনা হইত তবে কি হইত প্রেমনে ধরিতাম রে। রাধার মহিমা প্রেম রস সীমা জগতে জানাতে কে। যদি গনা হইত তবে কি হইত কেমনে ধরিতাম দে। হরে কৃষ্ণ। সো উইল রিড টেক আ ভার্স ফ্রম দি ভগবদ গীতা অ্যান্ড দেন উই উইল স্পিক অবাউট জাস্ট অ্যাজ উই হ্যাভ সং দ্য সং অবাউট লর্ড চৈতন্য। সো উই উইল স্পিক অবাউট লর্ড চৈতন্য টুডে from the 9th chapter and verse 11. Avajananti mamudha manushyam tanum ashritam param bhavam ajananto mama bhuta maheshwaram. Fools deride me when I descend in the human form of life. They do not know my transcendental nature as the supreme lord of all that be. We'll read only one para of the purport because it is a very long purport. Purport by Srila A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada. From the other explanations of the previous verses in this chapter, it is clear that the Supreme Personality of Godhead, although appearing like a human being, is not a common man. The personality of Godhead who conducts the creation, maintenance and annihilation of the complete cosmic manifestation cannot be a human being. Yet there are many foolish men who consider Krishna to be a merely powerful man and nothing more. Actually, he is the supreme personality of Godhead as confirmed in the Brahma Samhita, Ishvara Parama Krishna. He is the supreme lord. ॐ अज्ञानतिमिरान्धस्य ज्ञानाञ्जनशलाखया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। श्रीचैतन्यमनोभीष्टं स्थापितं येन भूतले स्वयं रूपा कदा मह्यं ददाति स्वपदान्तिकम्। Vandeham Shri Guru Shri Yuta Padakamalam Shri Gurun Vaishnavamscha Shri Rupam Sagrajatam Sagana Raghunathan Vitam Tam Sajivam Sadvaitam Savadutam Parijana Sahitam Krishna Chaitanya Devam Shri Radha Krishna Padan Sahagana Lalita Shri Vishakhan Vitamscha Namo Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prishthaya Bhutale Srimate Bhakti Vedanta Swami Iti Namine Namaste Saraswati Deve Gauravani Pracharine Nirvisesha Shunyavadi Arshatya Deshadharma Namo Mahavadanyaya Krishna Prema Pradayate Krishnaya Krishna Chaitanya Namine Gauratshe Namaha Panchatattvatmakam Krishnam Bhakta Rupa Swarupakam Bhaktavataram Bhaktakyam Namami Bhakta Shaktikam He Krishna Karuna Sindho Dinabandho Jagatpate Gopesha Gopika Kanta Radhakanta Namostute Tapta Kanchana Gaurangi Radhe Vrindavaneshwari Vrishabhanu Sute Devi Pranamami Hari Priye Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhara Srivasadi Gaur Bhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 So we welcome all of you for the Sunday feast program. First of all, before I start, I would like to take blessings of all my seniors. In fact, Ramarajya Prabhu is one of the most senior counselors and devotees of our congregation. So it was a little embarrassing for me to get introduced by him, but thank you Prabhuji so much. So we sang this song, Yadi Gaurna Hoito. So before coming to the Hare Krishna movement, most of us must have not heard about Lord Chaitanya. Definitely we have heard about Lord Krishna, but about Lord Chaitanya is, how many of you have heard about Lord Chaitanya before coming to the Hare Krishna movement? Good. They are very pious souls. And even if we have heard about Lord Chaitanya, it would have been not as much as we know when we come to the Hare Krishna movement. So today we will be, because Gaur Purnima is fast approaching, many of us would be dreaming of being in Mayapur Navadvip during this time of the year. But somehow, because of time, our jobs and our life here, we can't be there. So, but as the acharyas say, by hearing about great personalities, we can remember them and we can also be in the dham. So today we will speak about Lord Chaitanya and how His advent is already predicted in many of the scriptures. Most of us are questioned by people that I want to see God. Can you show me God? So even when once a devotee asked Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur that I want to see God, and Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur said, okay, you go and wash those utensils there and keep doing for a few days and then you will be able to see him. So that person kept washing those plates, and then Bhaktisiddhanta Maharaj once asked him, so you want to see God? So he said, no, I have already seen God through my service. So when Krishna was there 5,000 years ago in this planet, how many of the people there could understand Krishna as Supreme Lord or God? Only a handful of people. Majority of the people considered him to be a great mystic person. And most of them considered him to be a normal cowherd person. So imagine, even if God comes in front of us, how can we recognize him? We can't recognize aspects of godly features in saints. So how will we recognize God himself? So Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came 500 years ago in Navadvip Mayapur for a specific reason. And what was that reason? Krishna explained that after speaking the Bhagavad Gita, when I went back to the spiritual world, I realized that I only gave theory. मैंने लोगों को भगवद गीता के माध्यम से सिर्फ थियरी बताया. I did not explain how to practice the Bhagavad Gita in their day-to-day life. For that reason, I feel I should come to this, specifically in this age of Kali, to teach how to practice bhakti. And for that reason, Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he incarnates as Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Rupa Goswami quotes this verse, Namo Mahavadanyaya Krishna Prema Pradayate Krishnaya Krishna Chaitanya Namine Gaura Tvishe Namaha. Namo Mahavadanyaya, I bow down to Lord Sri Chaitanya, who is non-different than Krishna. Namo Mahavadanyaya Krishna Prema Pradayate, who has come to give Krishna Prema Pradayate, give. Krishnaya Krishna Chaitanya, he is non-different than Lord Krishna. Krishnaya Krishna Chaitanya. Namine Gaura Tvishe Namaha. And he has come in what complexion? Gaura complexion, in golden complexion. We see that there are four yugas. What are those four yugas? Satyuga, Treta Yuga, Dwapar Yuga and Kali Yuga. Anybody knows what is the duration of Kali Yuga? Kali Yuga lasts for 4,32,000 years. Dwapar Yuga is two times Kali Yuga. So if we term Kali Yuga as X, X is equal to 4,32,000 years. Dwapar Yuga is 2X. Treta Yuga is 3X. And Satyuga is 4X. When I'm talking of 4X, 3X, 2X and X is the duration of years. So for example, Satyuga will be 17,28,000 years. The Kali Yuga started and 500 years ago before, in 1486. When each of these yugas, thousand such yugas, becomes is called as one Mahayuga, or rather, all these four yugas put together is called one Mahayuga, and thousands of such Mahayugas is equal to one day of Brahma, which is equal to 12 hours of Brahma. And this 12 hours, within this 12 hours, there are 14 manvantras or 14 manus, and each manu lives for 71 such Mahayugas. And which Manu we are now in? We are in the seventh Manu. And in the seventh Manu, 28th cycle. Matlab, harek Manu mein 71 Mahayugas hote hain. So, 28th cycle ke Dwapar Yuga mein Bhagwan Krishna avatarin hote hain. Krishna comes down as he is on the 28th cycle of Dwapar Yuga. And immediately preceding that cycle, Krishna comes only once a day, once in a day. And immediately after that Dwapar Yuga, Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu appears. In other yugas, there are other yuga avatars. But in the seventh Manu, 28th cycle, Kali Yuga, Krishna appears as Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu himself. So you can imagine how much fortunate we are, because we are born in that Kali Yuga of the seventh Manu, 28th cycle, where Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has come as the Yuga Avatar. So we will take up the first verse which describes Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu as the Supreme Personality of Godhead. It is from the Srimad Bhagavatam and the very famous verse, Krishna Varnam Tvisha Krishnam Sangopangarsha Parshadam Yajyai Sankirtanai Prayai Yajanti Hi Sumedasaha. So what is the meaning of this verse? The translation is, in this age of Kali, intelligent people perform congregational chanting to worship the incarnation of Godhead who sings the holy name of Krishna. Although his complexion is not blackish, he is Krishna himself and is accompanied by his associates, servants, weapons and confidential companions. So you can see here that Krishna Varnam means it is directly telling that Lord Chaitanya is Krishna. Krishna Varnam. Varnam means also means that he always speaks about Lord Krishna. Krishna Varnam. Tvisha a Krishnam. But his complexion is a Krishnam. What is Krishna's complexion? Gold. Then Krishna's complexion is Shyama, the monsoon rain cloud. Or can say darkish blue for common people understanding. So what is Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's complexion? Golden. So it is a Krishnam. And Sangha Upanga Parshadam. So he comes with his followers, with his close followers and with his servants. Yajyai Sankirtanai Prayai Yajanti Hi Sumedasa. So what is his weapon? In the other incarnations, the Lord has various weapons. What are the various weapons the Lord has? Sometimes he carries a disc as Krishna, sometimes a bow. The name of Krishna's bow is Saranga. What is the name of Krishna's disc? Sudarshan. Sometimes he carries a mace, like in the form of Lord Vishnu. Vishnu carries a mace. When he came as Lord Ram, he carried bow and arrow. Lakshman used to be very good in sword fighting. But what did Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu carry? Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu carried the weapon of Sankirtan, the weapon of the holy name. There is a very beautiful analogy which is given by one of Srila Prabhupada's disciple. All of you have seen a bow. Bow dekha hai apne. So what are the various parts of the bow? The bow, the main bow, you know, the body of the bow. This is compared to the four paramparas. What are the four paramparas? Sri Parampara, Madhva Parampara, Kumar Parampara and Rudra Parampara. So these are the four paramparas through which we should understand who God is. These are the Vaishnava paramparas. And where do we fall in? We fall in the Madhva Parampara. Why? Because it is very special, because Brahmaji is the main person, the starting point. And in between, Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu comes. After Madhvacharya, Mahaprabhu Chaitanya comes in this parampara. And therefore, this parampara is called Brahma Madhva Gaudiya. Gaudiya means, because Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was born in Bengal, the word Gauda, Gauda Desh, or West Bengal, comes to prominence. So, Brahma Madhva Gaudiya Sampradaya. So, this the bow has four parts, representing the four paramparas. How does the bow get connected? Through a string, through a dori. And this dori is, the acharyas explain, is Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And of course, when you have a bow, there should be a arrow. Now, why does Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is the connecting aspect of all the four paramparas? All the four paramparas spread Krishna consciousness or preach about Lord Krishna as the Supreme Lord. But they, all the acharyas came in various time and various place and various circumstances. So Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu at the end, at the start of Kali Yuga, when he came, he took two aspects of each parampara. What were those two aspects? From the Sri Sampradaya, who the Acharya is Ramanujacharya, he took the aspect of Ananya Bhakti Seva, means worshipping Lord without any tinge of karma and jnana. Ananya Bhakti Seva. The second aspect he took was Bhakti Seva, Bhakta Seva, sorry. To serve the devotees. Krishna is pleased when he is served or when he sees his devotees are served. He is pleased when his devotees are served. So, Bhakta Seva hi Bhagavan Seva. So, this aspect of Ramanujacharya, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu took. The second sampradaya, Madhva Sampradaya, Mahaprabhu took Mayavad Nashana. Madhvacharya was very powerful acharya and who used to preach against Mayavad. Mayavad is that philosophy which says that God and Jiva or Jiva and Paramatma are one, which is not true. So Mahaprabhu took this aspect of Madhvacharya and also the aspect of deity worship. If you go to Udupi, you will find very strict standards of deity worship. It is in Karnataka, and the Madhva Sampradaya Acharyas, they perform, they worship Udupi Krishna with great love and devotion. From the Rudra Sampradaya, where Vishnu Swami was the Acharya, Mahaprabhu took two aspects again. Total dependence on Krishna. And the second aspect he took was spontaneous bhakti, Raganuga bhakti. The same Vishnu Swami reincarnated in Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's Leela as Vallabha. And then he went on to establish the Vallabha Sampradaya, which is also called the Pushti Marg. Many Gujaratis, they follow this Pushti Marg. They worship Lord Krishna in the form of Bal Gopal. And from the last Sampradaya, which is called the Kumar Sampradaya, Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu took two aspects again. One is exclusive shelter of Srimati Radharani. And the second aspect is worshipping the Lord in Gopi Bhav. So all these eight aspects, Lord Chaitanya was like the string. He took each of these two aspects and gave the philosophy of Achintya Bheda Bheda Tattva. Simultaneously one, but different. This is the philosophy of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu always used to say, just like when you take a drop of water from the ocean, and if you compare the qualities of the ocean with the drop of water, the qualities will be the same. But the drop is infinitesimal and the ocean is infinite. So this is the meaning of Achintya Bheda Bheda Tattva. The living entity is one in quality with the Supreme Lord, but is infinitesimal. Anu, and the Lord is Vibhu. So now we have finished describing the bow. Now there is the arrow. There are three parts to the arrow. The arrow has a shaft. The arrow has a feather-like thing at the back, which gives the direction. And the tip of the arrow is the sharp point of the arrow, which can pierce. So the Acharya clarifies that the shaft is what? Whom? Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Sarasvati Thakur. Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Sarasvati is the shaft of the arrow. And the feathers, six feathers, they are the six Goswamis. The six Goswamis established all the temples which you see in Vrindavan today. They wrote innumerable books on the Vaishnava philosophy. Jiva Goswami himself has written 4 lakh verses. Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu spent a lot of time with these six Goswamis. He preached to Sanatan Goswami very specifically in Banaras. He spent a lot of time with Rupa Goswami. So all these six Goswamis, they are the pillars of our Sampradaya, the foundation. And Bhakti Siddhanta Sarasvati Thakur is the shaft, and the arrow part, the main pointed part, is whom? Is A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada. And when this bow and arrow is taken and it carries the holy name and it pierces our heart becomes free of all the anarthas. So this is the power of the holy name, and this is the weapon which Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu brought with himself. Now we go to the next verse, or the next shloka from the scriptures which determine Lord Chaitanya as the Supreme Lord. It's from the Vishnu Sahasranam. Now it says, Suvarna Varno Hemango Varnangas Chandanangadi Sanyasakrit Shamaha Shanto Nishta Shanti Parayanaha. So we'll take the first part. Suvarna Varno Hemango. This comes in the Vishnu Puran. Now Vishnu Puran is a very wonderful scripture which contains Vishnu Sahasranam. It contains 1,000 names of Lord Vishnu. And in this Vishnu Sahasranam, this verse appears. It says, Suvarna Varno Hemango. The Lord has a golden complexion. And how many of you have seen sunset or sunrise? Most of us. That exact color, molten gold, that is the color of Lord Chaitanya. So you can imagine how beautiful Lord Chaitanya was. When we see the brahmacharis in saffron, we get so happy because that color is so effulgent. Similarly, when we used to see the body, you can imagine the entire person is orange, for our understanding, orange, and golden complexion. How the eyes can take up such beauty, impossible to comprehend by words. The Lord's body is also smeared with sandalwood pulp. And what does he do? Sanyasakrit shamha shantha nishta shanti parayanaha. He accepts the renounced order of life and is samaha shantaha. He is totally controlled, very peaceful. Nishtha, he is having firm faith in chanting of the holy name. And shanti parayanaha, he makes the environment full of happiness and peacefulness. And the acharyas explained, it is also that the Lord, when he comes down, he will defeat the Mayavad philosophy. So in this regard, when this verse, Suvarna Varno Himango, there is a reference given that when Lord Krishna's naming ceremony was done, where it was done? It was done in the Goshala, because Nanda Maharaj was very afraid that, you know, Kamsa, if they do it, you know, dhoom-dham se, if they book a very lavish hall and they call so many people, Kamsa will come to know. Because he was on the lookout for young babies, killing young babies, and he was sending Putana to kill all those young babies. So, on the advice of Gargamuni, they did this naming ceremony in the Goshala. And Gargamuni predicted that this boy has not come just now, he has come in previous yugas. In the Satyuga, he has come in the Shweta color. And when he comes in the Shweta color, he has four hands. He carries Tulsi Mala, chanting beads. He wears a sacred thread and is a young brahmachari and is known by the names Hamsa. When he comes in the Treta Yuga, his color is Rakta, red. And he has four arms, his hair is golden. And he has the paraphernalia of Yajna. Because in Treta Yuga, the way of performing sacrifices, or rather understanding God, is through sacrifice. Whereas in Satyuga, it was through penance. And in the Kali Yuga, the Lord comes in Pita form, that is yellow. And now he has come in Shyama color, that is in Dwapar Yuga. So clearly Gargamuni predicted that the Lord appears in yellow complexion. And when the Lord took sannyas, he specifically took up this aspect of preaching against Mayavad. And two personalities he converted. Who are those two personalities? It is said, a preacher is one who attacks the big pandit, you know, big person. Just like, you know, many of you watch cricket match. You know, when the opposition team targets the captain, and when the captain's wicket falls, so half the team's morale is down. Similarly, when a great non-devotee is made a devotee, just like Lord Chaitanya made Jagai and Madai, and Lord Nityananda made Jagai and Madai. If Jagai and Madai can be made devotee, all of us can also be made devotees. Similarly, Lord Chaitanya targeted two personalities during his life. One was Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya, and other was Prakashanand Saraswati. It is said that just by seeing the beauty of Lord Chaitanya, both these personalities, 50% of their, you know, non-faith got evaporated. Just seeing the beauty of Lord Chaitanya. When Lord Chaitanya first met Prakashanand Saraswati in Varanasi, Prakashanand Saraswati was sitting on this sort of big asana, you know, raised platform. And Lord Chaitanya just came in that room and humbly sat, you know, somewhere there, you know, the peechhe. And there was a washing place. So Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu sat there. So Prakashanand Saraswati saw that Lord Chaitanya was sitting so far and near the washing area. So he personally came down and caught Lord Chaitanya's hand and he said, you are a sannyasi from the Bharati Sampradaya, from our Sampradaya. So please come and sit with us. Don't sit in this dirty place. Because Prakashanand Saraswati did this menial service of coming down from the asana and going to, you know, giving his hand to Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, and the acharyas explained that he got delivered. So it is by menial service that our ego and our atheism can be destroyed. Just like Bhaktisiddhanta Maharaj told that person, first you do this service and then you will understand who God is. So bhakti means devotional service. That without devotional service, without doing practical service, our bhakti is very empty. Next verse is from the Garuda Puran, which says, Aham Purno Bhavishyami Yuga Sandhau Visheshatah Mayapure Navadvipe Bhavishyami Sachisutah. In the first part of Kali Yuga, I will appear in my complete spiritual form in Mayapur, Navadvip, and become the son of Sachi. In the next part, he says, Kale Prarthana Sandhyayam Lakshmi Kanta Bhavishyati Daru Brahma Samipastha Sanyasi Gauravigraha. So these two verses explain two aspects. One is where he was born, and second, what did he do? So let us take the first aspect. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was born in Mayapur, a subsection of the holy town of Navadvip, as the son of Mother Sachi Devi, in the year 1486, 4500 years after the beginning of Kali Yuga. So we already mentioned this. So Navadvip is a place which was 500 years ago considered to be a seat of learning. Just like you have today, you know, of course, you can't compare, but then IIT or IIM, Ahmedabad or, you know, Bangalore, these are the places where people die to go. Many of the engineering cadre people, they like to join IIT, considered to be the most prestigious university for engineering. Something like that it was during those days. Navadvip was considered to be a great seat of learning. And in such a place, Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu took appearance. Which month? In this month of Falgun, or the month of March. It was a seat of learning, but most of the people there were always engaging in debate. They were engaging in sense gratification because they were studying the scriptures but without understanding the whom to worship. The scriptures are studied to worship God, but they used to study the scriptures without God. They used to worship Chandi Devi, Kali Devi for material benefits. They used to conduct a lot of debates. They used to spend a lot of money in their daughters' marriages, sons' marriages, and in such a way they were engaging their life. And during that time, before the advent of Lord Chaitanya, already, you know, his associates had taken birth in Navadvip, and prominent amongst them was Sri Advaita Acharya. Sri Advaita Acharya used to his heart used to pain seeing the people in Navadvip, you know, wandering into these scriptures without even understanding who is God, without having any taste for holy name. Not a single person used to take the name of Krishna. Imagine Bhagavad Gita without Krishna. Once Srila Prabhupada had gone to one Gita Sammelan, and he was astonished to see that so many speakers were speaking about Bhagavad Gita, but none of them spoke about Lord Krishna. So this was the situation, something like that in Navadvip. So Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu appeared just in a great family, in a Brahman family, as his parents were Sachi Devi and Jagannath Mishra. And as soon as he appeared, he started his work. Not even one day he wasted. As soon as he was born, when he started crying, he made the ladies induced to chant Hare Krishna. And only when they used to chant Hare Krishna, then he used to become quiet, which is very parallel or similar to the pastimes of Lord Krishna in Vrindavan or in Mathura. For the first 24 years of this life, Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu remained a householder. In fact, when he was 14 years, he got married to Lakshmi Devi, who was incarnation of Srimati Radharani or Lakshmi Devi, you can say. And at the age of 14, he got married and he went to East Bengal to do some business, you know, make some profit. But by that time, he was already a great expert of Nyaya. He had started his own school and he was one of the, very strong debaters. And everybody was afraid of him. It was at this time he defeated Keshav Kashmiri also. So when he went to East Bengal, by the time he came back, he came to know that his wife Lakshmi Devi had died of a snake bite. And then after some days, because his mother wanted him to get married again, he married Vishnu Priya, who was the daughter of Sanatan Mishra. Now, at 24 years, from 14 to 24, Lord Chaitanya lived a life of a grihastha. During this time, he went to Gaya, he got initiated by Ishwarapuri, came back, completely changed man, chanting the holy names of Krishna. And then, at the age of 24, he did the most wonderful thing which nobody could of us even imagine. What did he do? He took sannyas. Why did he do that? Because he wanted the non-devotees, the Mayavadis, the so-called impersonalists to make progress. And how can these people make progress? By showing respect to a sannyasi. In those days, sannyasi was considered to be a very respectful person. And as soon as, even in our sampradaya now, it is said that if you don't bow down to a sannyasi, if you see a sannyasi, say you see Gopal Krishna Maharaj comes, and if you don't offer full dandavat, that is for the men, or for the women half dandavat, you are supposed to fast for the whole day. So that is the power of sannyasi. So the Mahaprabhu Chaitanya took sannyas for delivering the impersonalists and the Mayavadis. And in the scriptures, in the Srimad Bhagavatam, there is a very beautiful verse which explains why Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu took sannyas. It says, Tyaktva sudushtajaya surepshitaraja lakshmin. Dharmishta arivachasa yad agad aranyam. Mayamrigam daitam ipshitam anvadhavat vande mahapurusha charanaravindam tyaktva sudustujaya surepshita rajya lakshmin. He gave the association of Rajya Lakshmi, means his wife, who was non different than Lakshmi Devi. Such a beautiful and adorable wife, such a virtuous wife, he gave up the association at the age of 24. Dharmishta arya vachasa yad agad aranyam. In order to follow dharma, he kept the word of a brahmana who had cursed him to lose everything and become a sannyasi. Once, before he became sannyas, or he took sannyas, Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu used to, after he came back from Gaya, he used to do night kirtans at Srivas Thakur's house. Many of you must have visited. It's a very small place, Srivas Angan, it's called. It is non-different than Rasasthali, the place where Krishna and the gopis do rasa dance. So the same place incarnated in Kali Yuga, in Mayapur, in a place called Srivas Angan, where Lord Chaitanya and the Pancha Tattva used to perform night kirtans. So, but this kirtan was not allowed. There was no special pass or something like that. Only the confidential associates of Lord Chaitanya could come into this kirtan. So there was a pious brahmana who was trying to enter this kirtan, but he could not. And when he saw Nimai coming once towards the Ganges Ganga to take bath, so he cursed, he took his Brahman thread and he snapped it and he said, "I curse you, because you don't allow me to come for this kirtan, you will lose your family life and you will become a sannyasi." Just to keep this vow or this curse of this Brahman, Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, dharmishta arya vachasa yad agad aranyam, he went to the forest or took sannyas. Maya mrigam daita ipshitam anvadhavat, he ran after the conditioned souls like us. When Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu took sannyas, for the first 6 years he went all over South India, and whomever he touched, whomever he saw, he gave Krishna prem. That was the potency of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. I was just talking to one devotee yesterday, one of our senior god brothers. He was a brahmachari here in the temple for many years, and for some reason or the other, he shifted his ashram from brahmacharya to grihastha. But he had not married. From saffron he had become white, which is allowed. Brahmacharis are allowed to become grihasthas. So he was traveling still to Mayapur. It was the Pancha Tattva installation time. First time the Pancha Tattva deities were installed. And he was with the brahmacharis, because he was still with them, though he was in white. So he went to this, to Mayapur, and he was Brahman Diksha, of course. So he could dress the deities. But in those days, because there were so many devotees eager to do the Pancha Tattva, they wanted to be inside the altar. So the devotees from Mayapur, they didn't allow him because he was in white. They said only saffron people can go inside the altar. So he was very disappointed. In fact, one of the senior brahmacharis of the Mayapur temple even shouted at him that how can, and because he was trying to peep inside the door and see how, what they are doing. And from behind, this senior brahmachari of Mayapur temple came and, you know, "What are you doing here? Don't you know that this is supposed to be only for brahmacharis who are in saffron?" So this devotee, and this devotee used to do deity worship in this temple for so many years. So this devotee got little disappointed. And in the night he was sleeping with the brahmachari in the ashram, and there was a knock at the door. He said, "Are you brahmacharis from Radha Gopinath temple?" So he said, "Yes. I heard there is one very good electrician amongst you brahmacharis. We need his help urgently." So that he was referring to that white brahmachari. So he was very good in electrical fittings and, you know, like that. Even many of the construction aspects of this temple, he has overseen that. So he said, "Yes, I am that person." So he said, "You come fast. For next 3 days, you have to be inside the altar. You have to do all the fittings of halogen and the electrical wiring and everything, you know, even the, curtains and all you have to put. And for next 3 days, that devotee was inside the Panchatattva altar making preparations for the inauguration of Panchatattva. So we can see how Lord Chaitanya is practically also so merciful. If you have a desire to serve Lord Chaitanya, Lord Chaitanya will give that immediate desire. He will fulfill that desire. So for the benefit of the impersonal sannyasis, Lord Chaitanya gave up all these things, his good wife. You know, he was a great grammar teacher. He had his own school. He has the best reputation of, you know, the best debater in those days. Everything was, he had defeated Keshav Kashmiri. Everything was so good for him. Just like many of our brahmacharis, they have so much material, you know, degrees and certificates and jobs, but they still give up all that to serve so menially and to serve all of us. So similarly, Lord, there is the same mood which is following down in parampara. So Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, with the same mood, he took sannyas. And this verse is one of the most important verses which describes this aspect. Then we'll go to the next verse. It's from Padma Puran. It says, Kale prarthana sandhyayam gauranga gotham mahitale bhagirati tate rami bhavishyami sachi sutah. I shall take birth as the son of Sachi, assuming a golden form in a beautiful place on the bank of Bhagirati, on the earth, in the first place of Kali Yuga. Now Bhagirati is the same as Ganga, because Bhagirati, Raja Bhagirati, was the person who got Ganga to the earth planet. So this verse explains how the mother Ganga is very dear to Lord Chaitanya. Just like Yamuna is dear to Lord Krishna, mother Ganga is very dear to Lord Chaitanya. It seems when Lord Chaitanya was very young, maybe around 7 or 8 years, he was very mischievous. He used to go to school, and after school he used to go and take bath in the Ganga. And during that time, the brahmanas and, you know, the people, the ladies of the town used to go there and take bath. So Mahaprabhu Chaitanya used to, Nimai, he used to play pranks on these brahmanas. The brahmanas used to do Gayatri mantra, so he used to go down and catch their legs and pull them. He used to suddenly go and sit on their head and say, I am Mahesh. They used to bring their offerings, plates, for puja, aarti. And he used to go in right in front of them in the water and say, I am Narayan. I have incarnated as, I have reincarnated. I am the same Narayan. So worship me. Like that, he used to play pranks. Sometimes he used to spit water in their ears. Sometimes he and his friends used to throw sand. After they have taken bath, once they come out, they used to throw sand. And because they were smartha brahmanas, they had to again go and take bath. Sometimes the ladies used to complain to Mother Sachi that your boy comes to us and says, if you don't make this offering to me, I will curse you that you will get an old husband. And sometimes he used to steal the ladies' clothes and take it to the gents' side and put there and take the gents' clothes and bring it to the ladies' side. So like this, he used to create a lot of mischief, just like Krishna used to do at the bank of Keshi Ghat. If you go to Keshi Ghat also, you can find that there are places which depicts this pastime in Keshi Ghat. So same, if you see the life of Lord Chaitanya as Nimai Pandit and Krishna's birth, childhood pastimes were very, very similar. Then we go to the verse from Narada Puran, which says, Aham eva kalo vipro nityam prachhami vigraha bhagavad bhakta rupena lokam rakshami sarvada. O Brahmana, I will deliver all the worlds, concealing myself in the form of a devotee of Lord in the Kali Yuga. Divija bhuvi jayadhyam jayadvam bhakta rupinah kalau sankirtana arambhe bhavishyami sachisutah. Please advent on earth as devotees in Kali Yuga. To inaugurate Sankirtan, I will incarnate as a son of Sachi. So here we will see why Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came. What are the three external reasons and what are the three internal reasons? The three external reasons was because Lord Advaita Acharya prayed so immensely for Lord to appear, Lord Krishna to appear. To fulfill Advaita Acharya's desire, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu or Lord Krishna came as Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Number two is that it was the time of the Yuga Avatar as such for the Kali Yuga. And as we discussed before, who better than himself should come and explain this message of Bhakti Yoga? So the Lord himself came as a devotee, and therefore one of the names of this is called Chana Avatar, because hidden incarnation. It's a hidden incarnation. And whenever Lord Chaitanya was called as Supreme Lord, he used to cover his ears and he used to say Vishnu, Vishnu, and he used to run away. So never he gave his identity as Lord Chaitanya or as Lord Krishna. And there are three internal reasons which we'll just mention in brief. What are those three reasons? To understand the glories of Srimati Radharani. What is so glorious about Srimati Radharani? What are the qualities, second one, what are the qualities in Krishna that makes Srimati Radharani so much affectionate towards him? And the third, to experience the happiness and the bliss which Srimati Radharani feels for Lord Krishna. So these are the three internal and the external reasons for which Lord Chaitanya incarnates, or Lord Krishna incarnates as Lord Chaitanya. And as the Yuga Avatar, he inaugurates the Sankirtan movement. And the last verse we will see is from Bhavishya Puran, which says, Anandashru kalaroma harsha purnam tapadana sarve mama eva drakshanti kalau sanyasa rupinam. O austere sage, everyone will see my transcendental form as a sannyasi in this age of Kali. I will be displaying symptoms like shedding tears of bliss and hair standing on end out of ecstasy. Now in the last phase of his life, in the last 24 years as a sannyasi, Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu travelled 6 years extensively to South India and other places, and wherever he went, he was like a touchstone. Anybody who saw him became fully absorbed in Krishna prema. That was the power of Lord Chaitanya. So for the 18 years, last 18 years, he stayed in Jagannath Puri. He did not leave Jagannath Puri. And every year, all his associates from Bengal used to come to Jagannath Puri to celebrate the Rath Yatra, where they used to worship Lord Jagannath. Now, who is Lord Jagannath? Jagannath is Krishna. Who is Lord Chaitanya? He is Krishna in the mood of Radharani. So, this was the perfect place where Lord Chaitanya could exhibit the internal reasons for which he came to this world. For the first 30 years, you can say, 24 plus 6, he could not exhibit. But with the last 18 years, he lived only for 48 years. For the last 18 years, which he spent in Jagannath Puri, every year during the Rath Yatra, he used to exhibit these symptoms, which is mentioned here. The Jagannath Rath Yatra was comprising of 7 kirtan parties. Each kirtan party had 2 mridangas. So totally there were 14 mridangas. And each kirtan party had a specific lead singer and a lead dancer. The first kirtan party was led by, lead singer was Swarup Damodar. And the lead dancer was Advaita Acharya. The second kirtan party lead singer was Srivas Pandit. And the lead dancer was Lord Nityananda. The third kirtan party was, the lead singer was Mukund Dutt and the lead dancer was Haridas Thakur. And the fourth kirtan party was Govinda Ghosh and Vakreshwar Pandit. There was a fifth kirtan party which was from Kulinagram and it was led by Ramananda Rai and Satyaraj Khan. The sixth kirtan party was from Shantipur. Who used to stay in Shantipur? Advaita Acharya. So Advaita Acharya's son, Achyutananda, was the lead dancer. And the seventh party was from Shrikhanda, where Narhari Sarkar and Raghunandan Thakur were the lead dancers. So these 7 kirtan parties, Lord Chaitanya used to be like a bee, you know, going from one kirtan party to another, and every kirtan party used to think that Lord Chaitanya is with us. And in each kirtan party, Lord Chaitanya used to dance in front of Jagannath. And when Lord Chaitanya used to dance, what did Lord Jagannath do? He just stopped. Ruk gaye wo. Aap log ne jab, bahut log ne gaya honge Jagannath Puri mein, bahut baar Bhagwan ruk jate hain. Suddenly, the cart moves and suddenly he stops. He doesn't want to go. And even when he wants to come to sit on the rath, he has his own ways of coming. Sometimes he takes a lot of time. He doesn't come. So similarly, when Lord Chaitanya was dancing, Lord Jagannath, who is Krishna, he just stopped. And then Lord Chaitanya used to go behind and used to push Dhirath with his head. And then the cart used to go ahead. So like that, and when he used to dance, he used to exhibit all the 8 qualities of Mahabhav. Like his hair used to stand on end, like branches of Simuli tree. His eyes, water used to come, pour, like syringe, you know. Aap log ne holi, abhi holi aa raha hai, toh आपने वो पिचकारी दिया हो, पिचकारी ना, पिचकारी से डालते पानी कैसे फास्ट आता है, तो उनके आँखों से अश्रु ऐसे फास्ट आ रहे थे. हमारे आँखों से अश्रु आते तो ऐसे ऐसे आते हैं, कभी इधर से आते हैं, कभी इधर से आते हैं, कभी अंदर ही रह जाते हैं, बट उनके आँखों से अश्रु ऐसे स्प्रे की तरह बाहर आ रहा था. कभी आप घर पर ट्राई कीजिए इसे, यू कैन सी हाउ इट कम्स. तो उस तरह, हाँ, और जो भी व्यक्ति, जो भी भक्त बाजू में थे, उनको वो भिगा रहे थे. ही यूज्ड टू मेक देम वेट बाय हिज लव ऑफ टीयर्स. समटाइम्स यूज्ड टू रोल इन द ग्राउंड, समटाइम्स यूज्ड टू बी लाइक अ सो लाइट लाइक अ कॉटन, ही यूज्ड टू जंप हाई इन द एयर, समटाइम्स सो हार्ड लाइक अ रॉक, ही यूज्ड टू जस्ट यू नो स्टैंड स्टिल, नोबडी कुड मूव हिम. समटाइम्स ही यूज्ड टू से ऐसे ऐसे हर एक पार्टी में, हर एक कीर्तन पार्टी में यूज टू यू नो फ्लोट लाइक अ कॉटन. सो दैट वॉज द मूड विच लॉर्ड चैतन्य एग्जिबिटेड, विच नोबडी कुड अंडरस्टैंड एक्सेप्ट फ्यू पीपल. वाई ही इज डूइंग लाइक दिस? एंड वेरी फ्यू पीपल लाइक स्वरूप दामोदर एंड रूप गोस्वामी, दे कुड अंडरस्टैंड. एंड दे यूज टू सिंग स्पेसिफिक वर्सेस टू प्लीज लॉर्ड चैतन्य. एंड फॉर दिस सेम पर्पज, इंटरनल रीजन्स, लॉर्ड Chaitanya exhibited during the Rath Yatra. There are other instances where Lord Chaitanya proved that he is the Supreme Lord. Once during he was reading about Varahadev, and suddenly he rushed to the house of Murari Gupta. Now Murari Gupta is one of the very close, is the classmate of Nimai, Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. They used to study together. If you see, the house of Murari Gupta is just behind the Mayapur temple. They are very close, houses were very close. So Mahaprabhu, Nimai went to Murari Gupta's house and he said, started shouting, Shukara, Shukara, which means bore, bore. So he entered the house of Murari Gupta. There was a DT room. In that DT room, there was a nice pot. Immediately, when Murari Gupta followed him and he saw that Lord Chaitanya has become Varaha, Varaha Rupa. He has taken Varaha Rupa, Varaha form, and he is lifting that pot with his tusk. And he is shouting, I am Varaha, I am Varaha. And then he says, foolish people in this world do not know that I am personal, I am not impersonal. And they beat me with their stick on my back because of this. You see, I am a personal, I am very personal, I am Varaha. And like this he was telling to Murari Gupta. And Murari Gupta, he said, Murari Gupta, you are Hanuman and I am Lord Ram. So like this, he showed one of the aspects. And then to Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya, he showed the combined form of Radha and Krishna. What beautiful form. Radha Krishna ekatanu hai. And to Ramananda Rai, he showed the combined form of Radha and Krishna. To Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya, he showed the Shadbhuja form, the form which has all the yugas, Lord Krishna, Lord Ram and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And in this various ways, during the Mahaprakash Leela, for 21 hours, Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu sat on the throne of Vishnu. Never he used to allow anybody to say that he is God. But on that specific day, he himself went and sat on the throne of Vishnu. And he was calling out people and he was revealing their eternal form. And to each person, he used to reveal a certain form. So in this, for 21 hours continuously, Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu revealed that he is none other than Lord Krishna himself. So in this way, throughout his life, he propagated the holy name. He never allowed anybody to say that he is God, or he never said that I am God. Once Srivas Thakur, they were in Srivas Angan, and Srivas Thakur showed, looking at the sun, and he waved at the sun. And so Lord Chaitanya asked, what are you doing? He said, can you cover the sun with your hand? So Lord Chaitanya said, Similarly, we know who you are. Just like the sun cannot be covered by hand, similarly your glories cannot be remain hidden. So in this way, many times devotees used to tease him and make little fun of him that you are actually hiding this truth from us, but we know who you are. You are the same Lord Krishna. So basically Lord Chaitanya has given us this holy name which we are chanting. Kaler dosha nijay rajan asti ek mahan guna kirtanadeva krishnasya mukta sangha paramraja. This age of Kali has ocean of faults, but has one benediction. By chanting this holy name, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram. We can cross over the ocean of nisayans, as Prabhupada says. But most important is, do we value the holy name? Once one guru had given his disciple this secret mantra. He said, I am giving this Hare Krishna mantra, and it is a very secret mantra, he said. So he said, the disciple very nicely accepted. He said, thank you, Gurudev. And he went out. And when, as soon as he went out, he took a rickshaw. And that rickshawwala was chanting, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram. And the disciple was surprised. He said, my Guru Maharaj told it is a secret. Now the rickshawwala is chanting. Then he went ahead. He saw some boys, they were playing with ball. And they were also chanting Hare Krishna Mahamantra. Then further he went ahead towards the bank of a river. He saw washermen washing clothes. And they were also chanting Hare Krishna. So confused, the disciple went back to the Guru. He said, Guru Maharaj, you told me that this mantra you have given me is secret. But how come I went out, rickshawwala is chanting Hare Krishna, the girls are chanting Hare Krishna, washermen are chanting Hare Krishna. So how is it a secret? So the Guru said, okay, you do one thing, I'll give you one diamond. This is a rare diamond. You take this diamond to all these three people and you ask them what is the value of this diamond and what will they do with it. Iska moolya kya hai aur ab is diamond ko leke kya karoge. So the disciple went to the rickshawwala and the rickshawwala said, I will use this because it is very sharp. I can remove my corn from my leg. Corn aata hai na? Paon mein corn. Matlab jada ho jata hai skin. To scalp nikalna padta hai na? To ye, I can use it for removing that. So the disciple said, oh my God, he doesn't know what is diamond only. Then he went, goes to the boys. They are playing ball. So they say, oh, this is like a ball, you know, something like a rugby ball. So we will play game with this diamond. So again the disciple was disappointed. Then he went to the washerman. The washerman said, oh, this can be used to scrub those things, you know, dirty things which cannot be removed by normal water or soap. So I will use that. We will use this for that. So the disciple came back and said, oh Guru Maharaj, none of these three people could understand the value, mulya, nor they could understand what exactly to do with it. So most of us are in this situation. We understand that we have to chant Hare Krishna, but somehow we don't know the value of it and how to use, how to maximize the benefit of having a human form of life and chanting Hare Krishna. So in short, in 10 minutes, I just thought that many of devotees have got initiated and it will help in help everybody in chanting, improving our chanting. So I took some tips on how to improve chanting. So we'll just finish in next 10 minutes, but I thought this will help all of us. So first of all, we should understand that there is no difference in the holy name of Lord Krishna and Krishna himself. Abhinatva nama naminam. Nama chintamani Krishna. What is that? Nama chintamani Krishna's Chaitanya rasa vigraha. Purna shuddho nitya mukto abhinatva nama naminam. So some of the tips are, first, please prepare, first of all understand that no difference between Krishna and his holy name, and some practical tips which I will just share with you is, when you, the day before you chant, the night before, mentally prepare yourself that I will chant my rounds tomorrow very nicely. Even if you are chanting 4 rounds or 8 rounds or 12 rounds or 16 rounds or how many ever rounds you are chanting, but chant a fixed number of rounds. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu himself every day used to go to which place in Vrindavan? Place called Imli Tal, where he used to sit so attentively and chant Hare Krishna every day. So the Lord himself sets an example. And it is said, he used to say that I will go and take prasad in the house of that devotee who chants 1 lakh names. If anybody had to call Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu for lunch, he means he had to chant 1 lakh names. Bhaktisiddhanta Maharaj told his disciples that if you can't chant 64 names, you are fallen. But Srila Prabhupada was so merciful on us, कि हमको उन्होंने सिर्फ बोला कि 16 माला करना. वो 16 माला भी हमसे बहुत मुश्किल से होता है, isn't it? Especially with the advent of the mobile. All of us are hooked more to the mobile than to our beads. So therefore, for my own benefit and for all of you, I thought we should discuss for 5-10 minutes on this aspect. So preparation. So please prepare well one night before. The next morning you have to chant. Mentally prepare for 5 minutes. Read something on Krishna book or read something from the holy name book. There are 2-3 books written by the ISKCON sannyasis on holy name. One is Mahanidhi Maharaj, Art of Chanting Hare Krishna. One is also written by Sachinandan Swami. So you can read such books or also read Satswarup Maharaj's book of Japa, on Japa reform book. So these books help us to improve our chanting or to mentally prepare ourselves. The next is time, place and mind. So what time you should chant? Morning. The ideal time is between 5 to 7:30 or 8. But even if that is not possible, if once Adhikesha Prabhu used to tell us that if you want to be a successful grihastha, you should finish your rounds before 10 a.m. 10 a.m., not p.m. 10 baje subah ke pehle aapka 16 mala ho. And you will see, if you once you start doing this chanting of Hare Krishna 16 rounds before morning, before 10 o'clock, you will feel it's like something heavy lifted off your shoulders. First of all, to chant early in the morning is most beautiful and is the most focused you can have chanting throughout any other time of the day. And during the rest of the time, once you finish your chanting in the morning, you can do so many other things. You can read, you can hear kirtan, you can hear lectures. So this way, place, which place to chant? Ideally, one should come to temple and chant. But if it is not possible, make your house a temple. That's what Chaitanya Mahaprabhu did. He told that, you know, please make your house, remain in your house, chant, take your hands, clap 3 times and chant Hare Krishna. That is what he preached to the common men. So most of us stay in houses, so we should make our house a temple. Get up early, take bath, sit in a quiet place and chant your rounds. And what is the posture? The posture should be erect, not one leg on the sofa, one leg down, or, you know, those who cannot sit down on cross-legged, they can sit on chair. But generally, it should be erect posture so that our mind is alert and we can constantly hear. And pronounce. Pronunciation should be very clear. The Hare Krishna Mahamantra, Prabhupada used to say, just hear. Just hear the Hare Krishna mantra. That's all. Nothing else to remember, nothing else to focus. Focus on the mantra. And generally what happens is the mind is so rascal that after finishing few rounds, बोलेगा अंदर से कितना अच्छा चैंटिंग किया तुमने अभी 5 माला बहुत अच्छा किया. सो इमीडिएटली योर माइंड स्टार्ट्स डाइवर्टिंग. अच्छा आज क्रिकेट मैच है, आज ये है, आज वो है. इमीडिएटली योर माइंड हैज गॉन बिकॉज द माइंड हैज ट्रिक्ड यू बाय सेइंग ओ 5 राउंड्स यू चैंटेड नाइसली. सो देन यू विल स्टैंड, गेट अप, लुक एट देयर, गो आउट, यू नो, सी सम सीनरी. सो इमीडिएटली योर चैंटिंग फोकस हैज लॉस्ट. सो कंट्रोल, पुल बैक द माइंड. माइंड इज लाइक अ रेस्टलेस animal. So you have to keep on focusing after every round. So there was one devotee, Prabhupada disciple, who said that after every round you have to refocus. Think that ye japa mal, ye jo round hai, mera akhri round hai. This is my last round. So once you finish that round, oh, thank God, I did. This could be my last round. Again chant so nicely, full focus. Like this. So one round by one round. Don't plan your daily activities during japa. It generally happens. Like for example, it happened with me today. Morning when I was chanting, I was thinking, how shall I start the lecture? How shall I end the lecture? Which song I should sing? What analogy I should give? So the mind keeps thinking on this. And the acharyas explained that if it starts doing like that, take a pen and paper and jot down those points. Don't chant when you have these thoughts. Just ensure that your thoughts are put into some paper or something like that. Don't recall events, that what you did yesterday, what you did day before yesterday. Basically, no planning and no recalling. And what is the mood we should chant? Mahaprabhu explains, Trinadapi suni chena tarorivya sahishnunam amanina manadena kirtaniya sadahari. So this is the mood which we should develop during chanting. And we should meditate on the Hare Krishna mantra, which Prabhupada has told us. What is the meaning? O Srimati Radharani, O energy of the Lord, please engage me in your service. Because if you chant nicely, but if you don't serve, that chanting is like empty bullets. Hindi movie mein aap dekhte honge na? यहाँ से मारेगा तो भी आदमी मरता नहीं है कभी. वो एम्प्टी बुलेट होता है, बुलेट ही नहीं होता उसमें. इट इज़ लाइक इफ यू कीप चैंटिंग हरे कृष्णा विदाउट डूइंग मच सर्विस, एनी सर्विस, विदाउट एनी फीलिंग, इट विल नॉट हैव एनी इफेक्ट, देयर विल बी नो चेंज ऑफ हार्ट. सो दिस मूड वी हैव टू कल्टिवेट, दैट ओ श्रीमती राधारानी, ओ एनर्जी ऑफ द लॉर्ड, प्लीज एंगेज मी इन योर सर्विस. And finally, chant, if you are becoming little serious, you can chant with more deeper feelings of separation from the Lord. You know, you may have certain deities as your favorite, like Radha Gopinath or Krishna Balram or Radha Madhav or Panchatattva. So you can pray to them, that they give you more taste for the holy name. Basically, whenever we come in front of the Lord, apart from our material desires, we should always pray that please get me taste, give me taste for the holy name. Because the holy name is the only way, only madhyam by which we can understand the Supreme Lord in this age of Kali Yuga. And that is what Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu wants us to do. Chant Hare Krishna. Prabhupada used to always say, chant Hare Krishna and your life will be sublime. Sublime means it will be so peaceful, it will be so wonderful that you don't have to worry about anything else. Everything the Lord will take care. So with this, I end my talk here. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, we thank Ram Govind Prabhu for his scholarly presentation by loudly chanting three times, Hari Bol, Hari Bol, Hari Bol. We also take this opportunity to welcome devotees and guests who have come for the first time. And they can, after the program Kirtan, they can meet at the Hanumanji Vigraha. There will be guest reception team and they can ask